What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to the Illinois Tech Dynasty. Week 13 is here, which means there are only two games left on the year, and this is the final conference game for the Wolfpack this season as they'll take on 8-2 Southern Florida from Raymond James Stadium. Illinois Tech needs a Houston loss and a Wolfpack win to reach the American Conference Championship, and it'll be hard to come by in this game. Southern Florida is very good. They have a hard-hitting, smash-mouth defense and an offense that is very hard to game plan for. And the Wolfpack defense will take the field first. Can they find a way to keep this offense contained? Zach Carroll sends it deep to Chris Barr as week 13 is underway. Barr from the 1 yard line, returning up the middle and nowhere to go, shut down at around the 22 yard line. Out comes Asiante Woolard, currently fourth on the Heisman top five and a very good dual threat quarterback. The Wolfpack are in for a long game on defense if they can't keep him contained. First down from the gun to give to Elijah Mack, their starting running back, as he works left and finds a first down of 12 yards. Defense already getting out of place, got to stay disciplined. Hurrying back to the line from the shotgun again, screen out to McCants as Dwyer can't make the tackle. Curtis there to slow him down, but McCants has another Bulls first down. Already pulling out the trickery and still moving down the field. Second and 8 from near midfield. Back to Mack, gets away from McKenzie. Hunter there to bring him down, but a 7-yard gain. That should have been a loss of a couple yards. Third down, Southern Florida. Illinois Tech bringing heat. Mack breaks one more tackle and still gets the first down. He is not being brought down on first contact. That's good for 4 yards. Backed up to first and 15 after a false start. In comes the backup, Trevon Sands, and he's got nowhere to go. That was McKenzie once again in the backfield. Now third and 9 a play later. Woolard from the shotgun looks to find someone open past the marker, and he does. He finds McCants again, 13 yards. Getting close to scoring range. Woolard again looking to throw from the gun, lobs it towards the middle, and McCants makes a grab between three defenders. What a risky throw, but it pays off for a first down. Southern Florida just marching down the field, first and 10. Delayed give, and Sands is wrapped up by Quentin McKenzie for a loss of 5 yards. Making all the plays right now for this defense. Now third and 15. Woolard from the shotgun. Check down Elijah Mack. Finds some space. Gets away from McCray. Gets away from Hunter. And dragging defenders in the end zone for a 22-yard touchdown. Bulls on the board. And what a play from Elijah Mack. This was all him. Went to the sideline for a couple plays. Came back in well rested. And made this top-ranked defense look pretty silly. Got away from McCray. Stiff-armed Hunter to the ground. And Washington and Curtis could just barely drag him into the end zone. Illinois Tech will take the field down 7-0, 5:19 to go in the first quarter, and a give to Anthony Bishop trying to work outside in the corner. Came down to stop the run. They end up losing 2 on their first play. Second and 12, Wolfpack come out 2 tight ends. Taylor looking, throwing downfield, and Jason Howard, tough grab for 14 yards and a first down. Same look for the Wolfpack on the next play. They come out 2 tight ends again. This time an option keeper. This is Taylor across midfield. And Taylor will avoid the contact. Pick up 24 yards. Seen a lot of different looks from Southern Florida so far. A little bit of 4-2-5. A little bit of 4-3. As Bishop carries to near the first down marker. That'll set up a 3rd and 1. And they'll come out spread. Give it to Bishop up the middle. But Danny Thomas has other plans. The star linebacker for Southern Florida. One of their best players on defense makes the play. Wolfpack not giving up quite yet. They go right back to the run, and Bishop is denied again. Thomas, the first one there, needed 2 more to help him out, but the defense for Southern Florida keeps it 7-0. This is not the start the Wolfpack wanted this week. Already a turnover, second down. This is Woolard to the outside, finds Dylan, breaks 1 tackle, hurdles over McCray, finds the first down, still on his feet. This defense is not tackling well at all. You can't blame the rain. This has been a pretty big issue for this team all season. First down after a 15-yard gain. Woolard back to the air. Finds Salomon across the middle. Not even putting zip on these throws, but they're finding a way to get there. Second and 8 nearing scoring range again. Woolard this time takes off the run. Uses his mobility. Breaks away from Davis and brought down by Dash Wyatt. 6-yard gain. Now 3rd and 2. Tight end in the backfield. They give it to Dylan. He's going to get the first down and dragging defenders to near the 10-yard line and an 11-yard first down. Bulls on parade. They are marching right now. First and 10. Woolard again looks to throw. Tries to take off to run. And Woolard inside the 5-yard line, lost a football, but scooped up by McCanson, a Bulls touchdown. They're up by 2 scores. Wyatt made the hit, but absolutely nothing going right for this defense so far. 14-0, offense back out there on offense. They need a score. Can't be down by this much this early to this team as Taylor rolls out on 1st and 10, and the corner crashed down. Trying to get that football to Bishop, and Bishop just standing there. Now 2nd and 13 is Jason Howard in motion as Taylor looks to throw over the middle and intercepted by Jackson. And the Bulls have it inside the 20-yard line. This is not what you want right now. Already down 14 points, and here come the Bulls once again. And you can blame the rain for that throw. That was intended for Archer, offline, and Jackson with the INT. Woolard back to the air on 1st and 10 to McCanson. He can't hold on. That should have been a touchdown as Hunter got beat. 2nd and 10. First quarter almost wrapped up. They go back to Mack, working right, and Mack near the first down marker, gain of around 9 yards. Maybe the last play of the first quarter, maybe 2 more left. They go back to Mack. Mack has the first down and is brought down at the 6 or 7 yard line. That'll take us to the second quarter. 2nd and goal now for the Bulls. Mack outside once again, and a touchdown for the Bulls. A 3-touchdown lead. Number 17, Illinois Tech in trouble. They are not off to a good start this week. Defense can't buy a stop. Offense can't stay on the field and get some points. And here comes the Wolfpack offense. Once again, 39 yards in that first quarter. 1 sack, of course, the INT, and the turnover on 4th down. They'll start with the run. Has not been very good for them so far, but Bishop finds 7. That puts them at 6 carries and 11 yards. 2nd and 3, Taylor to the outside. There's Archer with the catch to spin move up the field. Little fancy spin move there, good for 17 yards. Brandon Archer coming to play this week. 2nd and 5 for the Wolfpack. They're in midfield already. Taylor to the outside finds Torrios, who can't hold on. Ball knocked free, 3rd down. From the 50-yard line, 3rd and 5, Taylor from the pistol drops back and looks to throw, and the ball is nearly intercepted for the 2nd time by McGee. And the Wolfpack offense once again out there for 4th down. 4th and 5, Taylor to Nick Grayson, trying to get the first down. He didn't get there. And the defense comes through for the Bulls again. A chance to make it a 4-score ball game in the second quarter. Woolard checked down to Dillon. And not much room to go as he's brought down on first contact. Thank you. 2nd and 6, Dillon in motion. Elijah Mack in the backfield. He'll stay in the block. Woolard trying to take off to run and is wrapped up by Corbin and Hunter for the sack. And that brings up 3rd down. Defense in desperate need of a stop here. Cannot allow them to keep this drive going. Woolard trying to throw to McCants, and the ball falls about 5 yards shy. And the defense will get their stop. Back to Illinois Tech on offense. No more mistakes here. Taylor trying to throw down the field and no one open. Southern Florida getting very effective blitzing and very good coverage downfield. They'll try the run on 2nd down and nowhere to go once again. Just a rough start for this run game, and it's 3rd and 10 for the Wolfpack. Illinois Tech comes out 5 wide on 3rd down, needing a first. Taylor to Archer, and he's got the 1st down. The offense having something with Archer on the receiving end, another 1st down for them. Got to find a way to build some momentum at this point. 1st down and going to a mid-screen. Torrios trying to get a block upfield and almost broke that one free. That's good for round 9. Same look for the Wolfpack on 2nd and short. Back to Bishop, and a 1st down carry gets them near midfield. And so far the run game, 2.5 yards a carry, is not going to do it. 2nd and 7. Taylor from under center. In comes the pressure. Taylor smack, gets it off in time, but nearly intercepted by Tajay Fullwood. Offense facing 3rd down once again. This time the Bulls only rushing 4. Taylor with time to throw. What a play call and what a throw to Eric Torrios. 1st down of 15 yards. Illinois Tech the closest they've been to scoring all ball game. 3 minutes to go in the second quarter. Taylor taking a shot right. Finds Archer once again over the head of Danny Thomas. And 28 yards that time. That'll get them inside the 5-yard line. 1st and goal. Taylor to Bishop and a touchdown. Risky throw, but it works out for the 1st score of the ball game for the Wolfpack. It's about time. Carroll on for the extra point as the Wolfpack will just take the 1 at this point. And Carroll kick up and good. And we'll take a quick look at the other American Conference game. Houston, Central Florida. And Houston, what are they doing? Down 16-7. So a lot of time left in both games, though. Illinois Tech needs a stop here once again. Woolard under pressure, and he's going to get away from two, but won't get away from Joe Washington. That's a great way to get this drive going. Second and 16, Woolard under pressure once again, lobs downfield. This is Barr who can't hold on. A little bit of luck there as Davis was a little lost in coverage. Now third and 16 for Southern Florida. Defense looking for one more play here. Woolard takes a shot but throws it downfield, finds Reed. Gets away from Davis. Gets away from Curtis. You've got to be kidding me again. Southern Florida makes it a three-score game. And this coverage and the tackling, it's inexcusable. If you want to play, you've got to make the plays. And Davis, where are you going? It's cover three. Your responsibility is that deep third of the field. You can't let people get behind you. You've got no help. Luckily, Curtis has the speed to get there, but Curtis also can't make the play. This defense is an absolute hot mess right now. 75 yards on five plays, but the extra point's no good, so a bit of a tough break there for the Bulls. Now only a 20-point ball game. A lot of time left for the Wolfpack. 1:32 to go and three timeouts. They try the run and is not going anywhere. Frustrating start for the run game this week. They'll hurry back to the line. 1:16 to go. Clock still ticking. Taylor taking a shot down the seam. Finds Shelton who makes the move back towards the left. Inside the 30 and finally brought down by Fullwood shy of the 20-yard line. That's a huge play for this offense. And they'll keep their three timeouts. First and 10, Taylor to Bishop, and what a throw, what a catch. 9-yard gain. Still not using their timeouts quite yet, trying to run this clock down as much as possible, and they have it down to 30 seconds. Taylor again throwing, this is a bubble screen outside, and Bishop's going to walk in untouched because Jason Howard is a blocking machine. Look at the blocking here from Jason Howard. Took the corner down at the line of scrimmage. Bishop got the football, then took out the safety, Fullwood, and Bishop walks in untouched. Make that two receiving touchdowns for him in this first half as the Wolfpack trail by 13. It's a long game, a lot of time left, but the defense has to wake up. A rough start for the Wolfpack on both ends has them down by 13 points to the Southern Florida Bulls, but they're fighting back. And this game's a long way from done, but the defense obviously in a bit of trouble. They cannot tackle well at all. On the other end, it's the Bulls tackling too well as a run game can't really get going for Illinois Tech. They only have 40 rushing yards between Bishop and Nate Taylor. Need to find a way to get this run game going and slow down the Bulls on defense as they'll start from the 20-yard line, first and 10. And a give to Bishop on the counter, and this has been the issue all ball game. No push up front, Bishop, 10 carries, 21 yards. We've seen games like this before. Normally, Bishop finds a way to wake up, and here he goes on second down, up to the 40-yard line. That carry good for 17. This is what we need to see. Everybody taking on somebody. Give Bishop room to work with the football. Let him make some plays. First and 10 for the Wolfpack once again. Back to the run game, and Bishop powers ahead for another first down. These past two runs have already beaten his first 10. From midfield, Taylor to throw for the first time this possession to the outside and trying to find Howard and intercepted. Again, you can't turn the ball over down by this much to this team. Second pick, that's got to be the last. This game is too important. Houston still losing to Central Florida. We need a win this week. First and 10 for the Bulls. They start from the 40-yard line. Another screen to McCants. Sheds one tackle as he picks up 8 yards. Tackling still not where it needs to be, but at least that wasn't a touchdown. Second and 2, they hurry back to the line, get the play call in, and a sweep right to Elijah Mack, finds the first down, sheds a tackle, and picks up 10 yards. Again, missing tackles, but again, not a touchdown. Defense still needs to find a way to keep these guys from getting yards as Woolard tries to run on first down and is sacked by Thomas Corbin for the first time. He's going to try to run on occasion, got to keep him contained. Corbin there, McCray there, that's good coverage downfield. Can the Bulls get those yards back on second down? Defense will love another sack here. Going to a screen, this is Hunter with the interception and taking it back the other way, but tracked down by Mack at the 36-yard line, and the defense comes through for the first time this game. They really needed this play. Taylor gave it away on a bad read, now a chance to make up for that and get this offense in the end zone. Second down, they'll go to the run game. This is Bishop again, wrapped up by Danny Thomas. Third down, Wolfpack. Got to get the first down here. Four receivers for Taylor. Bishop stays in the block, has time, finds Howard working inside, cuts back outside, nearly breaks that one free, but 17 yards are in the red zone again. Got to find a way to score. Bunch look this time. Taylor to Jason Howard trying to get the first down. He's got it. And the Wolfpack down to the 5-yard line. Got a chance to make this a one-score ball game, first and goal. In comes Abraham Barrow for the first time. There's Danny Thomas there to make the play, but Barrow finds three. They've got this down to the 1-yard line. This time is Bishop up the middle and finding the end zone for the third time this ball game. It's a one-score game. Just like that, they're back in it. Got to find a way to keep this momentum going. Defense back out there, down by 6 points. They'll start with Elijah Mack on the ground. Mack finds a first, breaks a tackle, and finally brought down after 15 yards. Mack looking a lot like Le'Veon Bell. Shows off the power, shows off the burst. Now as Woolard on second down, taking off the runs. Got the first down inside the 40 and sliding in Illinois Tech territory. To the 37-yard line, back to Elijah Mack up the middle. Mack breaks one tackle, but quickly brought down after 9 yards. They're getting close to scoring once again from the shotgun. Woolard, pump fake, throws downfield. Dowdell can't make the tackle, and McCants in for the score. 28 yards, and just like that, it's a 2-score Bulls lead. Again, the coverage, the tackling, it has to be better to win this game. 34-21. Another 13-point game. Taylor downfield, and Torrios with the catch, with the contact. Good for 20 yards or back in Bulls territory. Third quarter winding down. They go to an option. Taylor breaks free and almost takes that for a touchdown, but tracked down at the 12-yard line. His third carry for 45 yards, and that is your third quarter. Wolfpack again down by 2 scores, but driving and looking for a score to keep them in this ball game. But if they want to win this game, it'll fall on the defense. Ball at the 11-yard line to begin the fourth quarter. Taylor play fake, looking towards the end zone, and touchdown Eric Torrios. He was uncovered, and the defense looked clueless. Taylor's third touchdown of the ball game through the air. This was a great play call. The play fake sucked in the linebacker, and Torrios, just look at the coverage. No one even close to him. Illinois Tech looking to make this a 6-point ball game. Taylor with the hole, then Carroll sends it through the uprights. It's a 6-point game, and time for another update from that Houston Central Florida game. Houston down by 5 with 10 minutes left. Can they find a way to get back in that game? Illinois Tech defense set to take the field once again as Carroll sends this ball deep to McGee. Finds a little bit of room to work with. Good blocking up field as he crosses the 40, crosses midfield, but tracked down by Dash Wyatt. And out comes the Wolfpack defense. This is where you make your stand. You cannot allow any more scores. You can't allow any more big plays. You've got to step up, put your big boy pants on, and get these guys off the field. No question about it, they need to stop right here. From the shotgun, Woolard to throw, pressure incoming, and they lost containment. Woolard gets the first down, breaks a tackle, and brought down inside the 25. That is not the start this defense needed. Already in field goal range, they go to Elijah Mack, sweeping this one left. Mack breaks one, dragged down by Kendrick Royal from behind. That's an 8-yard pickup. Second and 2, and Woolard delayed give to Mack. Breaks one tackle, breaks a second, and gets the first down. That's a bad spot, but he probably earned it. Just unbelievable second effort from Elijah Mack. Now Woolard to the air, looks left, and this is incomplete for Reed. Woolard now 11 of 17. The defense able to change their personnel up a bit here. Second and 10. Mack gets it, trying to get outside, and Hunter slowed him down just enough for someone to make a play, and they lost 2 yards. More like Hunter got run over, but now third and 12. Woolard steps up and looking to throw. This is McCants down inside the 5, but not going to get the first, and Southern Florida will settle for the 3 points and make it a 37-28 ball game with 5:40 left. Game still in reach, but the Wolfpack need to score quickly. This is Archer with the reception. That's another first down catch for him. Been a pretty busy day. 5 receptions, 75 yards. Not too shabby. First and 10. Taylor play fake. Pressure throws off in time to Archer again. And another 10-yard gain. Just call Brandon Archer. Missed the first down this game. Another first down for the Wolfpack as Taylor throws under pressure. Gets it off in time to Torrios. Chased down from behind inside the 15-yard line, but good for 43 yards. This was a really good job by Torrios getting off the line against press coverage. And if it wasn't for that, maybe a sack on Nate Taylor. But the offense back in the red zone, just like that, second down. Getting close to the four-minute mark here. Strong eye look, a give to Bishop. Not much room to run, only good for 4 yards. Obviously in four-down territory here. Fourth downs haven't been very kind. Jay Miller in motion on third down. Bishop gets the football, runs right up the middle, and walks in untouched for his fourth touchdown. And the Wolfpack down by three. Extra point will make it a two-point game, but 3:29 left. And the defense, you cannot allow another score. From the shotgun, Asiante Woolard, Elijah Mack offset left. Woolard will throw, actually takes off the run on first down and will slide after a 5 yard pickup. Second and five for the Bulls. This is going to be a give on the delay to Elijah Mack. Sheds a tackle, sheds two more. He just can't be brought down on first contact. That was Corbin and Kendrick Royal. First and 10, another delayed give. Elijah Mack works this one to the right, gets away from Dowdell, and tracked down by Dash White, who's having himself a great game. 2:41 to go, delayed give to Mack once again, and Dash White gets run over, but Mack can't keep his balance. That's a 1 yard loss, timeout Wolfpack, third down. This could be the ball game right here. Illinois Tech will bring heat. Woolard flushed out the pocket, trying to get outside. Curtis contained, and Woolard can't get the first fourth down, and they will punt that away. 1:48 left and two timeouts for Illinois Tech. A long way to go as they start from their own 20-yard line. Taylor takes a shot right, and Howard can't hold on. He's been so good this game. You've got to make that catch. Minute 43 to go now, second and 10. Taylor pressure, trying to run, and is sacked, and they end up losing 6 yards. Kelvin Bronson gets the pressure. Now third and 16 for Illinois Tech. Taylor looks, throws right side. There's Howard again, and a first down of 21 yards. Fullwood late the boom, but a first down for the Wolfpack. Clock still ticking. Minute 6 to go. Taylor looking, throws off his back foot to Bishop, and they end up losing a yard and calling their first timeout. Down to 59 seconds. They've only picked up 14 yards. Second and 11. Taylor looks, throws outside. Howard, that's a tough throw. That was a really tight window, but he finds 7 yards. Clock still ticking down to 40 seconds. They'll hurry back now, third and 4. Taylor looks to Bishop, and he can't make the grab. Fourth down, and the offense back out there, 35 seconds left. Already 0 for 2 on fourth downs, needing a big one here. Taylor across the middle. Jason Howard with the catch, and the clock stopped at 31 seconds. They're holding on to that timeout for field goal range. This is Taylor looking outside to Nick Grayson, and what a catch near the sideline. Down to the 32-yard line, Nick Grayson gets off the line with ease and makes a great catch. And the Wolfpack in field goal range, but they want to get a little bit closer. First and 10, 23 seconds left. Bishop gets the football, cuts right, and only able to find 3 yards. Illinois Tech will hurry back down to 10 seconds. Timeout still in their pocket, second and 7. Taylor keeps it, gets the first down, gets him inside the 20-yard line, and that is going to get them the field goal they want. 35-yard try for Zach Carroll, and the Bulls call their first timeout, trying to ice the kicker, Zach Carroll, in the same position he was in week 10 against Cincinnati. Game-winning field goal. Carroll kick all the way, and he sends it through the uprights, and the Wolfpack take week 13. 10-1 on the season, and Zach Carroll, the freshman, with two of the biggest kicks of this season. Illinois Tech will survive somehow, and it's the freshman with the cleanest jersey on the field with the biggest play of the ball game. Illinois Tech, don't ask me how, but they got the job done once again, and Anthony Bishop, player of the game, 4 huge touchdowns. Not a lot of yards, but got the scores. Nate Taylor, 367 yards throwing this game for 3 touchdowns and 2 INTs. On the ground, it was Bishop and Taylor combined. They got this team down the field those last couple possessions. Everyone in the receiving game making plays, but none bigger than Brandon Archer. When this offense was struggling, those third down conversions from Archer were pretty big. Only 6 tackles for a loss this game. We got to Woolard a couple of times, make that 3 sacks, but of course, almost wasn't enough. I mean, he was running pretty well, made some smart runs, had some big runs, but the big guy this game was Elijah Mack for them. Sophomore running back, he'll be causing us fits for years to come, but he was pretty consistent at breaking tackles and causing a lot of headaches for us. And I'm not going to lie, I enjoyed this game, despite all the headaches, despite all the broken tackles, despite all the things that shouldn't have been happening, like the broken coverage downfield from Davis on that one third down. But into week 14 we go. We have climbed to number 16 from 17, and Houston took an L. Central Florida able to finish them off, as we are now the number one team without a doubt, but the American Conference Eastern Division, a little bit of a question mark here. It could be Central Florida, it could be Cincinnati. It's going to come down to this final game. The Bearcats take on Tulsa, 5-6 against 6-5. Central Florida on the road at number 25, Southern Florida. So somehow, despite the loss, they still climb in the rankings. It was a good game. Both teams deserve a little bit of credit. It was a great game. They took us down to the wire. But here we are looking at this final regular season game of the year, final home game of the season, Senior Day, taking on the Notre Dame Fighting Irish. And what a tough game this is going to be. We all remember the game against Notre Dame in year one. We got our butts kicked. Couldn't find a way to stop Kaiser and Josh Adams in this receiving corps. Now we're dealing with Brandon Wimbush, and the receivers are still here. Equanimeous St. Brown, CJ Sanders, Corey Holmes, Chase Claypool. Very, very good receiving corps here in Notre Dame. And our secondary is going to be in trouble if we can't find a way to shut these guys down and get pressure on Brandon Wimbush. But that, guys, is it for the episode. Thank you for tuning in. Season 3, we might be wrapped up with this sometime in the next 2 weeks. That's my goal. Thank you all for tuning in. Stay awesome. I'll see you guys next time. Have a nice day.